competitive.
Hello, I'm Andrew Dyer, and welcome to the special March Madness edition of the Roundball Report, the only show in the area dedicated to highlighting the excellence of the high school, college, and professional basketball teams which play in the Washington metropolitan area. And here with me again is my co-host, former Holy Cross High and Georgetown University star, Monica McNutt. Monica, welcome. It's March Madness time.
It is March Madness. Thanks for having me. Glad to be here. Got lots of hoops to talk.
Without a doubt. We're going to get right into it. We got our guests here, Mark Gray of the Shadow League and Afro-American newspaper, and Jimmy Fly, fresh back from the MEAC tournament.
Yes.
We've had folks ably filling in like Mark, and we had Ray Rogers here last week. So we've been doing our best. You know, everybody tries to eat. Everybody's been trying to eat. Well, gentlemen, so what's your thought? Did the selection committee get it right? There's always going to be some exceptions.
Well, and as crazy a year as it's been, I don't think how they could get anything wrong. Mm-hmm. I mean, I guess there's some people that could look at a team like USC on the outside looking in. You look at a team like Oklahoma on the inside looking out. But for the most part, this has been one of the few times I don't really have much of a beef with anything that went down because the season has so many different ebbs and flows. You never really had a handle. I don't think there's been a dominant number one team. So put everything into the mix. They did about as well as could be expected. So how is it that we can have all these players around the country and nobody from the area is in the tournament?
That's the story. They said this is the first time since 78.
And there were only 32 teams in the tournament at that time. So you could lose a heartbreaker in the ACC. Like, you know, those of us who are old enough to remember triple overtime, NC State,
yes.
You know, Maryland. Sorry. I mean, you don't know anything about
it. Yeah. Talk to your dad about it.
Lynn Elmore and the boys. Mm. Lynn Elmore had game. Mm-hmm.
John Lucas.
John Lucas.
David Thompson.
Man.
Mm-hmm.
Probably
professional tennis player and NBA point guard.
Nice. But it's ridiculous that, and what's even more insulting is we got all this talent around the country.
Number one in the country.
And the home state team, Maryland, couldn't get invited to the not invited tournament. You're not invited to the not invited. What is that?
Don't they have a third tournament?
There is a third.
I don't know that one.
That would be beneath
Unless it's a warm weather trip. John Thompson was always good about getting those warm weather trips.
Well, that's the first four, and let's go to the actual main people, the big boys, so to speak.
The field of 64.
Virginia, the number one 62. Overall seed. But if you look at historically in Tony Bennett's run, when they've been great the last 3 or 4 years, their record against non-16 seeds is below 500 in the tournament.
Well,
can't score.
Right, and that's the whole problem mm-hmm. with Virginia. The key to Virginia is 70 points. They get to 70 points, they win. Period. Nobody's going to score 70 points on them. So if they can get the 70 points, they're going to win a game. It's really that simple. But their defense is just unbelievable.
I like Arizona coming out of there. I think they got the Sean Miller factor. They got all the talent, and I think they're playing
so
for their coach.
You read my bracket in the back of the room.
I told you. I had already picked mine.
Well, no, I got Arizona coming out of this bracket. They got the best player in the country, Ayton, 22
Ayton,
points, 11 rebounds.
Two.
When I look at this tournament, I always look at teams that have pro players mm-hmm. on the roster. When you look
pro
at the Final
no
Four.
No matter the position?
Well, yeah, because you look at the Final Four over the years, mm-hmm. you look at who makes it into this Final Four and who wins it. They all have at least two, if not three, NBA caliber players.
Well, that Villanova team.
Josh.
These guys are NBA players now. Brunson and
Kentucky.
And
Mikal Bridges was a youngster on that
Kentucky
team.
Has a couple of bigs and some wing mm-hmm. players that really play big in turn. But I'm going to tell you something. Don't sleep on Tennessee. Rick Barnes has been playing great defense. They scoring from the perimeter now. And what happened in the SEC tournament final, I think, helps them out a lot because you're talking about a team that had a chance to do something great against Kentucky, and it was right there, and they made two critical mistakes down the stretch. That's going to make them better, mm-hmm. and I think they, once they come down off the disappointment of the SEC, they're going to be a tough out. That's a tough team to match up for. To be honest with you, I got my eye on Kentucky. I think Kentucky's peaking at the right time, man, and we all know They got the best team that money can buy that has not been caught or implicated in the FBI, FBI
well,
scandal yet.
After he goes on to another school.
I got an upset
so
special.
Time he, okay, what's that?
Loyola, number 11 seed, beat Miami in the first round. They got a point guard transfer, Clayton Cluster, out of Arizona, Iowa State, transferred over. I think they're like 22-4 when this guy starts for them. Their team is well coached, going to pull off a first round upset. But Nova's coming out of this bracket. I got Nova playing Cincinnati in a.
You mean Arizona?
Yeah. Arizona. Zona.
Zona.
Zona. No, we got okay. Nova later.
Gotcha.
All right, let's go to the next region. The East, this is where you got your Villanova. They're battle tested. To me, they sound like the best team, but they've lost to some teams that they really shouldn't have.
And they got beat handily, too, late, especially late in the season. But they got Brunson at mm-hmm. the point. This kid, Mikal Bridges,
right.
is developing into NBA talent.
Back.
Right. And they've
they
been
enough, do they have enough size up top?
And that's
they
the
can score the basketball.
Well, they can
they
score.
Have
they can
size when they won the title.
They can true. They can slash.
Well, they had the one kid that was
the
with
one.
The Wizards last year.
Yes, they didn't have a ton.
Mm-hmm. And they're a perimeter-centric team, liking them, you know, shoot the ball. That's the whole key with Villanova to me, is that ability to get a post score in crunch time. You know, late in the ball game when it slows down, can they get that shot? But they do everything well.
They got Jay Wright coaching.
But think about that.
Some talent and some great coaching.
The one thing they don't have is size. And you got Purdue, a major conference team loaded with seniors, and they got 2 7-footers.
You can't trust a Big Ten team.
Other than Michigan State.
You can't trust any of them.
Well, do we do bold predictions now or later in the show?
Fire
away. Big Ten team gets out of the first weekend.
You get out of to the first weekend?
No, nobody.
Okay.
I don't like the dynamic of them playing their tournament too early. I think that the best of the four teams probably would be Michigan. I trust them their perimeter shooting. But just something about the Big Ten this year, they come off
as
overrated.
So you got Villanova coming out of here? Who you got coming out of here, Mark?
I like Villanova.
Okay.
I do.
And I got Texas Tech and Wichita State as teams to watch out for.
And I do think Alabama.
With that point guard?
Yeah, and Avery Johnson has proven that he can coach.
They won't be playing no 3-on-5 games in this tournament, so they're going to go down.
You like Alabama over Tech?
Yeah.
I think Alabama. That's
going
to
be a really good game.
I personally am taking Wichita State out of this region.
Good pick.
That's a good pick. They got they're veteran lady. Let's go to the next region. I got Villanova coming out of that region. Now Xavier, they got a lot of Gonzaga's tough. Michigan's tough.
North Carolina
and Providence is playing well right now too.
And Carolina's found their defense. I think they ran out of gas in the championship game, and then when you can't beat Virginia as a defense.
I'm actually going with chalk on this one. I got Xavier coming out because the Blewett is their best players
Blewett
are seniors.
Blewett is great, but
Blewett also has been his greatest when other teams make idiot-proof mishaps.
Mm-hmm. Like wow. Georgetown.
I got North Carolina coming out of this round. Just
do
I think
you?
Joel Berry, I think this is going to be a bracket where we see experience really play out.
And I got upset special, South Dakota, the Jackrabbits, Mike Dom, the Dominator, 6'9", center, shoots threes, 25 points a game. That team's going to knock off your Big Ten.
I know technically by seeding that's an upset special, but I would not be surprised if that happens. However, I actually got Ohio State going Elite Eight.
I got North Carolina coming out of here.
Yeah.
North Carolina's got experience.
Who you got, Mark?
And they're going to play Gonzaga.
I would probably lean towards Carolina, too. I just think that, to the point, Joel Berry, college basketball, such a point guard-oriented game.
Yeah, but going back to Jimmy's thing about pros coming out, are Joel Berry or Luke May, the two best players, or either one of them NBA players?
Yeah, but they're smart Carolina basketball players.
And they've got
a coach if he felt like NBA player regardless of position, because I think the exception to that rule is your point guard.
Well, and North Carolina, because they got pedigree, and they got McDonald's All-Americans. Then they got Happy Meals on the bench that might be not.
Let's go to the last
But they're still
region.
6'10", 7 feet.
Midwest, Kansas, who actually, I think it's between Kansas and Xavier, who are the weakest of the number
Can't
one
trust
seeds.
Them. Can't
yeah.
trust Kansas.
That's why they put Duke in this bracket.
And I like Duke in this bracket.
They got to clear the path for them.
I actually like Michigan State coming out of here.
You must have been reading my brackets because I have Michigan State. The only reason, you know, I can't pick Duke, so that's just out. But but the reason they put them in there, and I'm going to tell you why, because Izzo is like 1-7 in March Madness when facing Duke. He has a big time losing record against Coach K.
You're killing your own argument, though.
But I'm no, because I can't take. It's not in my DNA to pick.
What argument is he killing as we get ready to go to break?
Pro players win in the tournament.
Miles Duke, Bridges,
Marvin
Michigan
Bagley
State.
Jr.
I can't pick Duke.
You do have two teams with pros, so this is.
All right. They're giving us a rap
New Mexico
signal.
State.
We're going to go to a quick break.
Upset.
We're going to wrap up. We get their Final Four selection and who's going to tear down the Nets, and then we'll turn the page to NBA Hoops with Mark Gray and Coach Jimmy Fly Hellmann right after this. So stay with us.